we were sorry that I took a lot of time to upload my next video, and because I was having some problem, and I was needed some tripod and all that. So now all the problems have resolved. So let's start with the fourth video lecture of my channel, which is about the platyhelminthes. Okay, this is the fourth phylum of the animal kingdom, and platyhelminthes is you can just know about this by just its name. Platy means flat and helminth means worm. Okay, so it's from name it is clear it is very flattened. It is flattened dorsoventrally, and its habitat is endoparasite. That is, it lives inside the body, the body of host. Okay, it can be a dog, it can be a man, it can be sheep, it can be goat, it can be anything. And I have cited one example, which is Fasciola hepatica. And its common name is liver fluke, and it is living inside the liver of sheep, human, dog. They can be free living also. Free living means they can live anywhere else. They can be living in the marine, they can live in the freshwater, they can be living in the terrestrial also. So I have cited one example, Degasia, which is the freshwater platyhelminthes. Okay. Next is the body symmetry. Body symmetry is bilateral types. Bilateral symmetrical means, I have also illustrated in the previous videos that bilateral symmetrical is that kind of symmetry in which you pass, if you pass one line from the center of axis of the body, then you can get the two equal halves. Okay. So you can pass the line from here longitudinally also, transversely also, and you will be getting the two equal halves. But the condition is that you should pass the line from the center of axis. Okay, next is the level of organization. Level of organization is organ level, because it is a more evolved phyla, and in more evolved phyla, the organ level is organ level of organization is found. Okay, so previously we have seen that tissue level of organization were there. Germ layer is triploblastic. It is also the first phylum where the triploblastic germ layer is found. That is the three layers: endoderm, ectoderm, mesoderm. Three layers, all the three layers are found here in the platyhelminthes for the first time. But as these three layers are present for the first time in platyhelminthes, the xylem is not well developed, so they are acylomate. Okay, they are not having the xylem. Okay, so this is the major characteristic feature of platyhelminthes, that is, they are triploblastic and as well as acylomate. So body form is dorsoventrally flattened, as I have talked earlier. That they are dorsally and ventrally flattened. Okay, dorsally and ventrally they are flattened, so they are just like idli. Idli is somewhat concave, but it is so much flattened like tape. Okay, the tape is very flattened structure. Hooks, spines, and suckers are also present in them. This is a specialized structure in the body which helps them to hook up, to stuck with the host or body organ, and it is very hard to remove them out because of these specialized structures. Parenchyma is the specialized connective tissue which is found in between the body wall and the alimentary canal. Okay, and the body wall, in between the body wall and alimentary canal, this parenchyma is present to transport the nutrients. Okay, so this is for the transportation purpose. Digestive tract is incomplete, that is, there is only a single opening for mouth as well as for the anus. The single opening serves for both the function of mouth and as well as for the anus. So this is incomplete type, and the digestive tract is completely absent in the tapeworm, which is the it is a fact, and you should remember this. Excretion and osmoregulation, both the things are performed by the same flame cell. Flame cells are a specialized structure in them which help them to excrete out their toxic material and also help to maintain the osmoregulation. Okay, so the osmosis, the whatever the osmoregulation is performed by platyhelminthes is by the flame cell. Nervous system is primitive type and ladder like. Primitive type because first time the nervous system has evolved in the platyhelminthes, and the ladder like. For this I have drawn the diagram of planaria nervous system. You can see it is the ladder like. Okay, here is the ladder like structure of nervous system is found in them, and the upper part is brain here, and this longitudinal nerve cord is found in them, and upon which the transverse commissure are found in them, and there is the branch lateral nerves. All these constitute the nervous system in them, and they are primitive kind. Okay, The reproduction is happening by both sexual and asexual forms, and they are hermaphrodite, means both the female and male gonads are found in the same organism. They don't have to look for the mate and go here and there for searching for their mate, and because they just have to bend their body, and the testis testis or the male gonad get inserted into the female gonad easily. Except the schistosoma. Schistosoma is dioecious, and in schistosoma, the male and female gonad are found in a different organism. If they follow the asexual mode, then they follow the transverse binary fission. This is the asexual mode of their reproduction. And if they follow the sexual mode, then the internal fertilization happens. That is, the fertilization happens inside the female body. Okay. Indirect development means the development will be having the larval form. The common larva found in the plagiomyces is Turbinaria, Cystoda, Tributoda, etc. And the most important feature of the plagiomyces is regeneration. And regeneration means if there any of the body parts get cut by any circumstances, then they regenerate it well. With the fully grown organ, they can regenerate it in a very short period of time. So planaria possesses tremendously this feature of regeneration. So it is the most special feature of plagiomyces. So this is all about the plagiomyces phylum. I hope you like the video, and if you have any question regarding this topic, then please comment me below, and please like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you.